The purpose of this project is to document the oral histories of former Forest Haven residents. Forest Haven was an institution created by Congress and operated by the District of Columbia government from 1925 to 1991. It was where DC residents with intellectual disabilities were sent to live lives apart and separate from the community.
That's a long time ago. When I was in Forest Haven, I went to much junior business, they went everybody to Forest Haven to open it up. Then I think they molded it up and moved all the cottage, called the clients to the cottage. And the cottage, it was made for all girls and boys. The Hawthorne, that's Hawthorne Cottage. And other side is the Zayda Cottage with the wheelchairs. Right across from the church, from the other side, that's the Zayda Cottage. Hawthorne's over here, and Dogwood's on next on that side, and you'll see a canteen next to it. You can buy sodas and stuff and all that. That's the canteen. And you go on the other side, you go see Maple Cottage. And Pine Cottage next to it on this side, on this line. And on the other side, you're going to see the other side. You're going to go up the street over here. That's Jones Hall and Negro Hall. Up to here.
Okay, dining rooms. That's another one. You're not done in there a long time ago. That's a year.
Let me see. We had a couple of parties in the dining room. We had cake and ice cream and night shift. I go to church every night at Paul Saban. And I say the prayers all the time for that. That was another year. And so, boy, he's blind. He's a church singer. I was the altar boy in Forest Haven. Now, in the school down at Forest Haven, they had a gas station there. You get some gas from them. You don't have to pay for nothing. It's free. But it's all you have to do. It's a long time. I made a whole lot of thousands of money when I was in Forest Haven, Buffalo Flores, and the Mexican School. I got a picture about that in my book. I should let y'all look at it.
That's why I was cut grass a long time ago. Like, we call it trapper. One of those.
No, boy, they, the human brother, they die. John Spread, you know that little show boys? John Spread, you know them? His brother died. You know a girl named Kayla Hawkins? She died. From Falls State, from Hawthorne Cottage.
Mm-hmm. We got Andre Lyles, that's one. We got Andre Lyles, Edward Hess, Guy Johnson, the Clifford Johnson, the show boy. He don't get no spanking, but his brother does. He cuss all the time. And he died there.
Vander Johnson. Yeah, the Vander Johnson and Edward Hans Johnson, he died. I got a picture by there, too. I should let y'all see that picture by him. It's over there. I left it over there. I got a picture by Forest Haven. I try to see that. I should let y'all see that.
Yes, it is.
It's that one client got married. His name, Lane Reed, him and his brother got married. Ain't Paul Saban. You hear about that? That's a long time ago. She used to be my girlfriend a long time. And that's what happened. The one client's out there one a long time ago in the girls' cottage. And she was talking here. I'm from here. I have a stand by the one. And she had a dress on that day. I had to catch him. I saved her life before she killed her. She was trying to kill her instead of throwing people out the window. You hear about that? You hear about that? That's a Hawthorne Cottage. I had to catch him on it so fast, my arms are just and catch him in. And she was safe. I saved him for one time. I saved him myself. Let me see. My brother was, he don't come visit me now, because I got two brothers, but I'm the oldest one in the family, so my mother and my father died. So she died in 1961. My father died in 1984. No, but they didn't come visit me that time. Nah. No, I feel sad because I wouldn't have been good enough because they closed their back down. Yes. Forest Haven is kind of mean with the clients, with staff, with clients. Had sex with clients, lost their job because I had got. The policeman had to get locked, staff up on their job. They put hands with a client on their job. They couldn't do that. But they did it anyway because they lost their job. But the other clients scared to tell somebody what's going on with doing the clients. They shouldn't do that on their job.
We didn't teach the clients very nice, I'll tell you that much.
Right. And the staff hit you with belts. and the boy is blind, and the other client scared to tell somebody. But I had to tell somebody, I had to fight for myself. We got to fight with the staff over. That was the year. And I took a baseball bat, put staff in the hospital. I busted staff in the head. That's a long time ago. But because the cottage with the staff, they're not doing their job right. They're not doing their job. They lost their job. And families with the clients, they lost their job. That was a year. But staff, other client friends say something to the staff that they lost their job. When police came up, police, 20 cars, the man had a shotgun working in the dining room. But he had 20, he shot a couple of clients and Paul saved him. Some client died. I moved out of 77, yeah. I was about 20 years old. 20 years old. That was 20 years old. Oh, they moved everybody out because they put out the community and put people in the group homes. That's what they did that for. Because the staff was not teaching class right, very nice, because the staff is mean to the clients. 20 years old. 20 years old. That was 20 years old. Well, I went with my parents. No, I wasn't here in the group home. Mm-hmm. Because information for group homes for clients. Some live with their parents and some live in the group home. They got group homes for clients and put some in the group home. I was in, they put, I went for all saving, they put me in DuPont Circle, Connecticut Avenue. But that church, it's got down the street from here. It's a church down there. It's a bank down there. But I also get a lot of change and I save money all the time. I count them on my calculator and add up how much it is. I count, add them up and put in the bank in it. They give dollar bills out there. I'm good at math, yeah. Nobody don't move math problem, but one person made me delete. And I still got, I was a teacher. I said, don't you have me? He said, don't you have me? You couldn't math? I said, if we got $18 and multiply $8, how much you had? What the answer would be? 18 times 8, you get 144. And 12 times 12 is 144. I'm good at math. See, I'm still good at math. Nobody still know, but my person. I feel good now. I feel better. I have a roommate. So I'm moving September 1st, because I ain't going to be here. I ain't going to be there more. I like to move. I got a map in my head. I can find a way around the city. That's the northwest side. This side, this is the northeast side. You're the station right behind you. Right the train. See? And because I not go to the doctor point on my own, that's easy. I not get the Washington Center from here, and I get the DuPont Circuit here, and I get the Union Station here. Let me see. I like pay music. That's another thing. I pay music. I sound real good now.
LMA Studios introducing Mr. Ray Charles.
What you say?